सदाशिवसमारंभा शंकराचार्यमत्यमा अस्मदाचार्यपर्यंता वंदे गुरुपरंपरा। I welcome you all with my love and respects. Today I'll continue on the yesterday's sutra, the sutra which I was elaborating yesterday. Ahimsa, Satya, अस्तेय ब्रह्मचर्य अपरिग्रहाः यमाः नॉन किलिंग ट्रूथफुलनेस नॉन स्टीलिंग कॉन्टिनेंस एंड नॉन रिसीविंग आर कॉल्ड यमा। दिस इज स्वामी विवेकानंदस ट्रांसलेशन एंड स्वामी सच्चिदानंद ट्रांसलेट्स यमा कंसिस्ट्स ऑफ non-violence, truthfulness, non-stealing, continence and non-greed. Yama is abstention from harming others, from falsehood, from theft, from incontinence and from greed. We need to understand Yama first. As I said yesterday, Yama is not just the law, the energy which makes the law into reality, law enforcement energy, both are called Yama. When you realize the source of both, you don't need to practice all these things, it will happen through you. Please understand. You are supposed to work for enlightenment. You are supposed to look in and unclutch. When you unclutch, this is the way your expression happens. Like a breeze, you will be untouched. These great vratas, I can say more than the word vrata, the word flow, that will be the right word. These five great expressions will be just your quality, it will be just flowing through you. Please understand. When a man does not have any thought during the breathing, his whole breathing is pure prana energy, no thought, pure prana energy. That is why he can just blow away the people. It's a pure energy. That is why the any word which comes out of that air directly gives you the energy and experience and elevates you. See, during the process, all the deeper process you do, nothing is used there except my word. I just say, let all the memories in your system be healed or disappear. That's all. Words. But they are so powerful, your very being shakes. Sometime it comes out in the form of word, are formless air. But whatever way it comes out, it just straight away starts working, creating energy in you. when you become prana, anything flows through you becomes prana. So when you become Brahman, the way of life you live is brahmacharya. So put your effort to become Brahman and clutching, then how you live is celibacy. The celibacy word is a too poor word to translate brahmacharya. Brahmacharya means living like God. You will live like God. You will live like God. So brahmacharya is not a vow or ordinary vrata. It is a wealth. It is a luxury. It's an extraordinary ecstasy. Brahmacharya is an extraordinary inner experience. Freedom from the other person, freedom from the partner, freedom from the other, without depending on the another body to give pleasure, just your own inner spiritual ecstasy, inner spiritual being. The other day I was describing this Divya Sariri, who sit around me as Divya Sariri. I was telling them that they were describing that when they get into that Kundalini experience and the spiritual experience, it is such an intense ecstasy in the body. I said, after this ecstasy experience only you can start the brahmacharya life. Because you don't need somebody from outside. Just remembrance, enough. You are there in ecstasy. You are there in bliss. Smarana matrena. Just by remembrance, the bliss. Smaranaanandam. Just by remembrance, the bliss. The ecstasy and bliss of every law here Patanjali describes as brahmacharya or non-violence. Non-violence is such a joy. It is not just a moral code. It is such an ecstasy. I can honestly tell from my heart, Abhayam Sarvabhudebhyo. I give refuge to the whole world. Not just intellectually, experientially. Somehow in my heart, that non-violence is residing as a wealth. Understand, it's there in me as wealth. These great vratas are not just vows, are rules to be followed, laws to be executed. They are wealth to be enjoyed. Understand, from the other dimension, celibacy is a too poor word, brahmacharya, living like God. It's a wealth to be enjoyed. Not having the need or the craving for another one body to give you pleasure is a wealth. Such big freedom. Brahmacharya is a wealth. Non-violence is a wealth. Aparigraha is a wealth. Aparigraha means living with minimal things. I am talking about living with minimal things, sitting in a golden throne and wearing the golden kandi. Because without these two also, I can be in the same highest blissful mood and express the same great truths beautifully and strongly, clearly, as I am doing now. Then we have the doubt, then why this golden throne and why this golden kandi? these two are here just to add the status to the great ideas I am expressing and I am representing. Not to me. Understand? If it is for me, without this, then I should not be able to express what I am expressing, what I am radiating. No. I can sit in an ordinary, not even sit on the floor, and express what I am expressing verbally or through energy. These are, see, in the ordinary human eyes, there are some things which adds value to what is represented. That is why in the Hindu tradition, on the deities and gods, we put so much of gold, so much of silk clothes, so much of valuable items, just giving a statement. So I am giving a statement to the world. The ideas which I am expressing, the ideology which I am representing is worthy of being worshipped with this golden throne and the golden kandi. That's all. That is the reason, not just me. Anybody who sits and teaches as acharya in the Dhyanapidam, I have given golden throne for them. Of course, even this throne is not golden. It is made out of copper and gold painted. Anybody who, in the ashram who conducts class, the young satsangs, who does the job of sharing these great truths, sits in golden throne and golden, wears the golden kandi. So it is a job. When somebody does that job, they receive that respect. That's all. The throne and the kandi is given for the truth which is represented. Sometimes I see funny scenes. These acharyas, they sit in the golden throne, wear the golden kandi and take classes and teach everything. In garden, he is a gardener. In the IT department, he is a software engineer. The throne is acharya. That's all. So these are like tools and instruments to give a statement, nothing else. Aparigraha means non-stealing, non-violence, non-stealing. These are great wealths. These great qualities are great wealths. Living with minimal things is one of the great wealth you acquire. Because your body and mind is prepared to live wherever you want. It is such a big freedom. Satya, Asteya, Aparigraha, Ahimsa, Brahmacharya. Please understand. The truth, living like God, being non-greedy, living with minimal things and non-stealing, and non-violence. These are some of the greatest wealths. If you think it is just a moral code, you have a wrong understanding. Then you will struggle to practice and you will always abuse others who are not practicing. Understand, in a right way, it is a wealth. Then you will have it. And if others don't have it, you won't blame them. You will only be sympathetic towards them. Living with minimal things, brings a tremendous grace and freedom to your body and mind. Living like God just makes you experience the ecstasy. Living with non-violence, you will have a deep, restful awareness inside you, understand? When you have violence towards somebody, please understand, you are having violence inside you. Violence is like fire, first going to burn you before you put it on others. Me not having violence is not just a moral code. I am in ecstasy constantly. Come on. It is just because I don't have violence inside and I just know my life's purpose. I'm just going ahead with my life's purpose. Having violence towards somebody is wasting your life, because at the end you will realize, oh God, you wasted so many years just because of your foolish violence towards somebody. You have come here to achieve something in your life, but you got stuck with somebody else's life. Surely you never come down to disturb somebody's life. You come down to enrich your life. But you are wasting your time and energy in disturbing somebody's life. Suddenly you will see a strong blow happening in your life and telling you, you wasted your life. That is the punishment for being violent and trying to disturb others' life. So, understand the truth of non-violence, ahimsa, non-stealing, asteya, living with minimal things, aparigraha, brahmacharya, living like God. Understand the truth of all these four. That is what is truth. Truth does not mean here, satya does not mean just like a parrot talking only the facts. Talking only the facts is one dimension of truth. Understanding the truths of all these things properly is truth. That is satya. Satya is not just talking the facts. It's a one dimension of satya. But satya means understanding the truths of life. And your whole body, mind and speech and everything in tune, aligned to the truths of life is satya. I bless all of you to have these great five wealths: ahimsa, satya, asteya, aparigraha, brahmacharya, as Patanjali describes. Ahimsa, satya, asteya, brahmacharya, aparigraha, yamaha. These five vows, these five wealths, let you all have an experience. Let you all achieve, experience, live, express, and radiate the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you.